Thank you very much for that speech, and both teams on the top half for their contribution to the debate. I'd now like to call upon the third speaker for the government.
Okay, Mr. Chair, the opening half discussed about very difficult things, but we say this motion is more simple, Mr. Chair. Why we prefer our world? Because we prefer the equality in the opportunity, because equality in the opportunity ensures every people's right to pursue the happiness. Under upper down, comparatively under upper down, people don't have the disadvantage in the tolerance received at birth, so they have the more opportunity to pursue their happiness. And we say our paradigm is better because more and more people will become happiness. That's all, Mr. Chair. So from the closing government side, I will analyze who has the disadvantage in tolerance received at birth and why inequality in opportunity is against the fundamental life or fundamental life of the individuals or against the happiness of the individuals. And secondly, why we prefer the world that every individual has every individual's equality in opportunity is ensured. Before that, two responses to the opening opposition side. Okay, so firstly, they say that under our paradigm, the people's discussion or discourse will be lost, will be decreased, and those mono discourse will be happening because they have the similar idea. No, Mr. Chair. So, ladies and gentlemen, what's the decide your idea or your ideology? We don't think your idea or your ideology is decided when you are born. Or we say that the experience decide your ideology through your life, Mr. Chair. Through your life, you contact with many variety types of people, and you experience a failure and sometimes become the winner. So, and then those idea or your idea is affected by the many people or by the many event in your life. So even if all people have the same tolerance, which doesn't mean that they have the same ideology, we believe they have still under our paradigm, they have the different idea and the discussion will both change, Mr. Chair. And moreover, secondly, they say that under our paradigm, under our world, we reduce the social welfare or social justice. No, Mr. Chair, because it is not exclusive. Even today, even under our world, the people cannot know who someone is someone failed because of their tolerance received at birth, or because of the effort, lack of effort, Mr. Chair. But still, in our world, we sympathize those people, and still we support the social welfare to the poor. We believe the social justice, Madam Chair. So their argument is completely not exclusive. Now, yes.
Your opening government willing to accept that all forms of experiences should be the same. Why do you contradict in your opening government?
Okay, so even if somehow it is the same, the who you meet in your life is different. What kinds of the incident you experience is different. That's all. So on to my first point. So, okay. So first of all, Mr. Chair, who have the disadvantage? disadvantage in the tolerance received at birth. We say that people, for example, people who have the lower IQ or who have the less, unfortunately, less beautiful appearance, or women who cannot be pregnant biologically, or disabled people. So why it is disadvantage in your life? Because, for example, if you have the lower IQ, you cannot promote your career, you cannot get the high salary, even if you do effort by studying much, unfortunately, Mr. Chair. Or for example, if you cannot become pregnant, you cannot have the baby. If you really want to have the baby with your partner, or for example, those disabled people cannot get high position in the company, in the real world, because they have physical or mental disadvantage. So we say that, this is unavoidable consequence, Mr. Chair. Even if they can, so we don't prefer those world that people have unavoidable consequence. People cannot avoid the disadvantage, and people cannot opt out from the disadvantage, Mr. Chair. So, okay, no, thank you. Sorry. So why we don't prefer those worlds? Because we say that inequality in the opportunity is so apparent, the opening opposition side said disadvantage will rather incentivize the people to do effort. But we have to recognize that even if they do effort, some people cannot opt out and some people cannot succeed. Mr. Chair, for example, even if you do effort, the life is decided by the traits you are born, Mr. Chair. So you cannot opt out from the disabled. You cannot opt out the body who cannot become the pregnant. So in this case, okay, people have the. We say that each individual has the right to pursue their happiness. For example, if you are a woman, you want to have the baby with your partner, but under their paradigm, some women cannot, because they are born biologically, they cannot have the baby, Madam Chair. Or for example, even if you promote your career, if your IQ is unfortunately and biologically lower to other people, even if you do effort by studying much, you cannot, and it is so disadvantage, Mr. Chair. So we say that because the every people's right to pursue happiness is so fundamental, and every people want to become happiness. So but some people cannot do because of the tolerance they are born, Mr. Chair. So in this case, okay, let's compare the both of world. Under our paradigm, they can avoid those disadvantages when they are born. Okay, even if you are poor, and even if you become the poor family, still the government can do efforts. Still government can give you the welfare or give you the scholarship, and if you do effort, comparatively, our paradigm can be the better life, because if you do effort, you can get your career, you can promote your career and get a high position in the society. So comparatively, we say that under our paradigm, more and more people can be happy because of without the disadvantage when you are born, and that's why we propose.
Thank you very much for that speech. I now like to call upon the third speaker for the opposition.
So, thank you, Mr. Speaker. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We think that the difference is beautiful. It's your compass to decide which way to go. We say when you identify yourself, You find your trait and you think you're different from other people and you start to differentiate yourself from other people. The biological difference plays a big role in identifying yourself and constructing your identity within that should be existing in the society. So weak closing opposition directly clashes with the premise of the opening government to say that identity construction will be much, much better. We say that will be much, much worse. So I'm gonna deal with two issues. First, about discrimination. Second, about identity construction. So let me deal with one by one, and all of those will be integrated in my points. First, about discrimination. Opening government and closing government also somehow repeatedly explain that disparity is existing in the status quo that's problematic. First, our stance is we can tackle after they were born with the experience of the life. For example, there is a medical treatment, there is a tax redistribution. That's why the government is existing in a status quo, and the government helps those people maximize their efforts and their happiness. We think that's perfectly fine from our side of the house. Secondly, it's better to do so because we can be reactive to their want. If they think they want to opt out of that characteristic, they can choose that choice. For example, there is a blind, there is a deaf people, there are some disabilities, there are some IQ lesser people, there are handsome people, and so on. When they think they want to opt out of that characteristics, we should offer them the hand to help those people. However, that should not be decided by the government at the birth, because everyone has a freedom and a choice to opt in and opt out from that characteristics. We say that's perfectly fine under our paradigm. It's completely arbitrary from the government side to decide at the birth, because individuals can enjoy your difference, can enjoy your characteristic. We think it's perfectly okay. No, thank you. So, moving on to the second issue about identity construction. Opening government came up here and taught us they actively look for the identity because everyone looks the same, everyone has the same biological characteristics, personalities, IQ, AQ, and so on. That's why this incentivizes people to do so. This is completely false, Mr. Speaker, because we are struggling to find our identity even in our reality, even in the status quo. We are looking for our identity and try to do parliamentary debate, because I differentiate myself from others, I differentiate myself from the other people who are doing academic debating and so on. We said it's perfectly okay for us to do so even in the status quo, Mr. Speaker, because everyone has the incentive to look for your identity. It's your fundamental need and demand inside from yourself. We say even in the status quo, the motivation exists. That's why their argumentation is not exclusive to their side of the house. Incentivization always exists in the society. We say it's untrue. So the question here is, what is the problem? It is when you find yourself identified. Mr. Speaker, we say on our side of the house, it's when you notice you're different from others. Because everyone has some differences, especially difference at birth gives you a clue to notice a way to go. For example, if you are better at English than mathematics, of course, you start to find a compass to go to that way. This is my superiority, then but the math is not my superiority. You can choose to opt into certain identity forming, and that is totally better to find yourself in the status quo. Thanks to the difference existing biologically, we can find a way to go. So why under their paradigm this will be undermined and hindered? But before that, yes, sir.
Your entire bench has been arguing about freedom to your own traits. But how is it freedom to your traits when these traits are imposed by nature?
Yeah. Okay, Mr. Speaker, it's imposed by nature. We accept. But because it's imposed by nature, it is beautiful. Because it's imposed by nature, it can be a compass for yourself to find your own way. So I'm going to explain why under their paradigm, this is going to be harsher. So, their ideal world is everyone can find their identity according to your experience and the social life and education and so on. But the fact is, it's much, much harder for everyone to understand what's your way to go. Because, for example, if you have an examination, you get 50 score at English, 50 score at math, 50 score at Japanese, 50 score at science. It's all same, right? Your friends also get the same score. It's not different, right? You're good at tennis, then other friends also good at tennis because you're biologically same, right? In this situation, how can you identify yourself and how can you find a way way to go. It's far more harsher for yourself to find yourself which way to go. There are numerous number of infinite number of choices around you in this society. You can be anything, but particularly in this situation, having everything say is completely harmful for your identification. No, thank you. So we think, for example, IQ, EQ are same. Everyone is just to some extent good at math and so on. We think that's completely problematic. So we say under our paradigm, with some difference, you can have a confidence in your choice. What do I mean by that? Confidence means you are confident to go in the right direction because you believe that your characteristic superiority is in this field. That's why you can believe in yourself. You can trust your way to go. However, under their paradigm, they cannot be confident anymore because they cannot believe that whether or not this is a way to go. They cannot believe which way is the best for themselves, which way is suitable for yourself, because you have to choose by yourself. However, the freedom is perfectly harshing to those people. We think that removing the said biological difference completely jeopardizes under identity construction. We think this is completely problematic. So, okay, what have I told you today? Firstly, we think that discrimination is completely solvable, even in the status quo, and according to their logic, you can assume that the technology to treat someone after they are born, we think it's perfectly fine from our side of the house. After they were born, we can treat these characteristics, assuming the technology to cure some disease, and so on. And at the time, it should be up to individuals. When they themselves find it not okay to opt into that characteristics, and they decide to opt out of that characteristics, this should be done. And secondly, identity construction is also harmed by their side of the house because you cannot find your way to go, and it's far more harsher for them, for yourself, and we think that's problematic. For all those reasons, we oppose.
Thank you very much for that speech. And I'd like to call upon the final speaker for the government.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have to differentiate the external facts and internal facts in this debate. The external facts, like social experience or social incidents or some facts or factors that are given by external factors, is like changes the direction of people, but actually it can also be changed by governments or some other factors. But we think what we say is the internal factors is actually unavoidable things because it is the natural things. And we think because it is also the external factors that individual cannot avoid those things. In that case, we think it is unfair opportunity for them to access to it. We think because also we think that choice can be given by the social experience, like from the community or teacher or parents or other things. But when it comes to the choice and by the social factors, individuals should be able to choose the choice by internal ability. But the problem here is because the internal ability cannot be changed, they have at the first place have no ability to take the choice that is given by the external factors. That's why that the opposition wants to give to the individuals. It actually cannot be taken by individuals. That's the problem that we want to take, and that's why we prefer the individual have equal opportunity, equal ability to access to the every right, and that's what we are saying from our product. So from the closing government whip, I want to explain to you two things. Firstly, we want to engage with the opening opposition, especially, and why it is their case not exclusive, and why their case is actually supporting the necessity of equal internal ability. And secondly, I want to explain to you why the unavoidable internal disadvantage is the matter to ensure the equal opportunity, rights, or freedom of choice, and why it's preferable. So, the first is engagement. The opening opposition told us that by having a difference, that people can be self-actualized. But we think that it is self-actualization that comes from the social matter. We think actually that people can easily obtain their nationalism, for example, obtain religion, but it's not internal factor. But having a community that they belong to, or a choice that people later on obtain, we think that people can actually self-actualize. And because people want to belong to certain ideology or certain things, that people are actively choose it, but it does come from the natural things, because if people have no idea at the first place in there. No, thank you. Also, they also say that the government, by having technology and imposing certain definition of value of life, everything, the arbitrary definition and which is bad. But we think that government or other actors in society is actually giving certain welfare to the people to avoid the negative externality, and actually, and that's why it's not mutually exclusive. And we think that actually the society defines what the social status is better, like rich is better than poor, and so on. And according to this, the society is giving a subsidy on an amount, and the society defines reasonable. In that case, the society defines what is the better life, and actually society imposes it. In that case, we think that there was a universal consensus on what the life can be better in order to maximize the choice. And what we want to impose is the ability that individual can easily take a choice at every moment. And at the boss, individual can have an equal opportunity in this, because they individual have ability. Because what we want to say is the avoidance of disability, for example, or the other things, which is unable to take certain choice in the future, and which is more detrimental. Yes, opening.
Then tell us once and for all how exactly you respect freedom of choice and you have a respect for diversity when you're imposing identical values and traits and nurturing intolerance toward diversity itself.
Diversity can come from the social experience, because each person can have a different perspective. But we think because the society is so complex and individual perceive the different social experience, in that case, we think the individual should be easy to take the choice. The problem here is that even if some context gives some certain choice for an individual, the problem is that individual cannot take the choice due to disability or due to the physical disadvantage and so on. And that's the problem while we're talking. No, thank you. And second, about an unavoidable internal disadvantage, why it's matter to ensure the equal opportunity, the freedom for life. Now we think the first place that all argument like increase the incentive to by having the difference, like we can increase the incentive to connect with others by having the innovators or something. And also the closing opposition told us that an individual can opt in or opt out in certain choice. And like it can be the converse in decision-making process. But we think that at the first place, the problem is, as we said, that the individual cannot take that choice at the first place, even if they feel different with others. Even if some people want to be a rich, as they have little IQ, as they have little physical disadvantage, they cannot structure be so, because they have lack of opportunity and physical ability to work with other people. And that's the problem at the first place. Therefore, their choice to be the others and incentives or motivation cannot be ensured at the first place, and that's the problem. Also, we also think that the choice, does not come from the nature, but comes from the social experience. Like we say that the community or teacher or parents or great novel or other things or great music can tell us that what is the good life for them. But the problem here is in that case, the individual should be equally choose the things. As the closing opposition example, no thank you, those who have more ability in English than the math. But if that person wants to be a math, wants to learn more math and be good at math, by reading a special novel about how math is good, we think individuals should also be able to be at math, be good at math at the first place, because we think it ensures that every variety of choice, and we think individuals should be able to choose every kind of choice that they want to choose. Because it ensures the equal rights. And at first place, the choice comes from the equality and opportunity. And we think individual preference is diverse, we think the individual should be able to take a lot every choice. In that case, we think that at the first place, the external factors is actually ensure and both paradigm. Like when people have no education, the hospital, government are insured, and also the government protect the crime, prevent the crimes. And because these kind of things are negative externality, and that's why these rights must be insured. The reason why we say that being the same with others in the trade is also should also be ensured as a right is because it is also negative externality, because individual cannot avoid those things for at the born age. In that case, we think individual cannot take at the first place. But we think it cannot also be overcome by the effort, because even if the individual make effort, if they have low IQ, they cannot compete with the higher IQ people, even if they have twice effort or double effort with these people. That's an unequal situation or unavoidable situation. And not to equalize that every capacity or ability to choose every possibility or possible choice, and in order to ensure that equal choice, we think it's preferable situation, and that's why we back to propose.
Thank you very much for that speech. I'd like to call upon the final speaker for the opposition to close this debate.
Firstly, I clarify our stance. Firstly, in this motion, assuming that technology exists, and in this case, we can't assume the technology to change trade afterwards. In this case, it is better for the nation's choice, as we already said, because we can compare the benefit with the harm in the reality or so. And secondly, the difference is necessary for identity, seeking the happiness, and choose the lifestyle, or so on. Because the lifestyle, or the all kind of choice, the fashion, or the clothes, is based on the difference. In this case, clearly, thanks to my great partner's argument, we prove that the difference is necessary, and is beneficial for society and our life. So, let's move on to rebuttal. To the closing government or the opening government. The closing government, they said the same trade is not arbitrary, the choice or so on. But people have the pride, have the identity, each other, for example, less IQ, but high academic ability. In this case, they have the pride or the identity. It is different of that. It is different one to one. So in this case, we cannot decide the best trade or so on. In this case, in their paradigm, I break the selfish premise in coming from the whole government. Government don't have the right to choose the best trade, because in their paradigm, the government try to deny the one people, the not smart people, or the less IQ people, the non-sports ability people like that. In this case, we cannot justify the such the choice. And moreover, other rebuttals are included in my criterion to the debate. In this debate, the crash point is so simple. The difference is good or bad. No, thank you. Thanks to my great brother's argument, we prove the difference is necessary. First criterion about this, about identity. Opening government said that in their ideal world, people actively find the action or the experience for seeking our identity. But people are equal. In this case, clearly they cannot choose all kind of things, because lifestyle, job, fashion, identity are based on the difference. No, thank you. For example, if I have the high sports ability, in this case, I make maybe I make effort to the maximize ability to play the soccer or so on, and I run every morning or so on. I choose such a lifestyle, ladies and gentlemen. So, but in that paradigm, we cannot choose because there is no reason to choose the lifestyle for the choice for the job. No, thank you. So in this case, they don't have the confidence, all kind of thing, or they don't have the dream or the job or so on. In this case, it is so harmful because they cannot get identity, the confidence or the dream or the ideal, the lifestyle or so on. In this case, the identity or the dream, such kind of thing is necessary because it is the will to live actively or comfortably in full life. So in this case, in the paradigm, the people cannot seek happiness causing.
Okay, we believe social experience got after you are born identify you. So why only traits received at birth identify you?
Okay, I explain about the second criterion in my point. Second criterion about the opportunity, ladies and gentlemen. Four governments said that some people don't have the opportunity, it is problematic. Of course, in some aspect, people don't have the opportunity, but, no thank you, they can't seek the happiness even in their paradigm, even in a paradigm. Because if people don't have the academic ability, in this case, people choose other choice, for example, sports or the other kind of things, the job which not necessarily for the academic ability or so on. In this case, it is not problematic, no thank you. And moreover, in this case, clearly, they can seek the happiness or the try to the maximize the ability, the suitable ability or so on. In this case, it is more better, it is beneficial for the whole the life. No, thank you. So, third criterion about discrimination. Even in the paradigm, firstly, the discrimination exists from the wealth or the effort or the other factor or so on. So in this case, of course, we concede in our paradigm, there is a discrimination, but we can't mitigate such discrimination according to by the welfare or the other kind of thing. So in this case, the discrimination cannot be the reason to propose this motion. So moreover, the people can get the sympathy or the will to help the people from the difference, ladies and gentlemen. In this case, it is so beneficial for the discrimination because, for example, people who don't have the good, no thank you, for example, people who don't have the good academic ability, such people exist. In this case, smart people try to help such people. Because people have the sympathy to such people, ladies and gentlemen. In this case, in our paradigm, more the support or the helping is workable in our paradigm. It is so the ideal world, ladies and gentlemen. But in their paradigm, the people use a little like, for example, they didn't make effort, so it is a self-responsibility or so on. In this case, that such people don't support each other, it is so problematic, and we cannot solve the